Well, someone on Facebook had indicated that they had started a new job and they were looking for some job tips to be able to maintain and keep their job situation where they have just recently been hired. And people submitted tips, and some of them were really great ones, particularly from Glenda, who works in the field of helping people with the employment matters. So shout out to Glenda for her excellent advice. And I just want to say some of the same things I said on Facebook in case you want to have it in film form, so to speak, in video form. First, I want to say, don't fuck the supervisors. It won't bode well if things don't pan out to be on good terms, so to speak, during the long haul. So it's best to just not trip that way. And also, I want to say, just, you know, recognize that you shouldn't be too free-flowing with your personal information in the workplaces, because you don't know what folks will do with the information once they have a hold of it. And don't treat your job like a second home with personal comforts all in your drawers and on your desk and so forth and so on. You want to keep it light, professional. You can have a little things here and there, but, you know, don't be doing spreads across your desk with a line of family photographs and a drawer full of lotions and personal effects and so forth and so on, especially if you have to roll out quickly. You want to be able to get all that stuff in like one bag, you know, because I had to do that. I'm talking from experience. I was ready. I had my bag and I was up out of there, and, you know, it was quick, fast, and it was, you know, compact. So, you know, I'm just telling you from my own workplace journeys. And also, just don't let yourself be disrespected, but don't get into the mode where you do the head shaking and, you know, and get indignant in a way where your body language is just spilling all over the damn place. There are ways to say things to people when you are disrespected without, you know, just going ghetto fabulous, so to speak. Also, be professional and be courteous. Please and thank you and excuse me go a long, long way, believe me. And also, you can have some work confidence. You can even hang out and, you know, have drinks with some people, you know. But just, you know, just don't, well, actually, I don't know about that drinking thing, because Glenda said something about that, and I think I'm on board with what she advised. Because sometimes when people drink, their lips get loose and they then regret. And I've seen some videos about Christmas parties that got out of hand and people just, you know, just got sloppy and, oh my goodness, and it wasn't pretty, and people don't forget when you look like a lush and stuff like that when it comes to the parties and over drinking and so forth. And when the word gets through the grapevine, you'll be labeled. And also, what else did I want to say? And don't be real loud. I have a loud voice ordinarily, but just try to keep your voice at a moderate tone, because sometimes when people are loud, other folks are intimidated, you know, and that would be their baggage in some aspects. But just don't, you know, be too loud. And also, be straightforward and honest and about integrity, because integrity is vital for reputational purposes. And what else did I want to share? Oh, you can be sharing and caring. You might want to bring some things to the office sometimes, some treats to the office sometimes for them to partake of, but don't overdo it, because some folks will abuse and take your kindness for weakness. So be kind and cordial, and you can be fun and laugh and smile. That's great. But just don't get into, you know, too many conversations where the informants and the spies can enrich themselves on your bounty. And just also, you know, be aware that supervisors have their proper places. And these days, some supervisors are in those roles and they have no business being in management, because they have management titles, but their ass need to be some goddamn where else with their attitudes. Some of them be power tripping, ego tripping, and some more. So, that being the case, they still are your superiors in the workplace, so you have to respect their positions and so forth and so on. But just be watchful, do a lot of listening, do a lot of watching and observing and checking out, you know, how people behave and people's countenances and whatnot. You know, a lot of times you can do better by being listening as opposed to doing a lot of talking, especially if you're new, you know, on probation, because a lot of times probation goes like 90 days or for a year or whatever the case may be. And then some people who are envious in desperation mode. So be watchful of those desperately envious people, because envy is a beast. And people who are desperate do desperate things. And don't be afraid to be yourself, be authentic, but you may have to tone down some of your authenticity in the workplace. That's very possible. But don't sacrifice or surrender to anyone who you are as your authentic self. Find out how you can balance it and keep yourself centered and keep yourself honest and keep yourself where you are a professional and that people can look at you and say, she can keep confidences, she doesn't violate secrecies and things like that. Let yourself become trustworthy, and that goes a long way in the workplace. Personality is more than 75% of being successful in job situations. You can have all of the college education, the degrees and so forth, but if your personality is junk, then people pretty much put you in a junk category. So just remember that your skills are very important. Your work ethic, being on time, being punctual, and taking your responsibility and offering to help others out. But don't overdo that either, because some folks want to dump on you. So just be generous in your time and your cooperation and your participation. But again, keep yourself centered in the areas that you are involved in your workplaces. Just don't go too much to the left or too much to the right. Just find the happy medium and work it and stay on your grind. And what do we do when opposition comes our way, so-called? We stay on our grinds and we don't get into victim mode. We are victorious no matter what goes on. And don't forget, when you're in the workplace sometimes in these meetings and things are getting on your damn nerves, don't forget to use those mudras. You can do mudras under the table. You can be under the table with your pyramid thing going on. You know, have a pyramid thing, getting strength that way. You can do a mudra where you have the, you go, how do you do this one? I'm just learning this one. You can do that. That's power going on. You can do this. You can do this under the table. And that will give you strength. You can feel the strength impartation when you're dealing with these issues that are nerve-wracking in some aspects and can rise your stress levels, you know. And don't be into your magical conversations in the workplaces, because most people in the world claim they're Christians, okay? And a lot of Christians think that anything dealing with the metaphysical is demonic and evil. So you don't want to be in a workplace, you know, talking about crystals and cauldrons and a lot of things that are in that arena, because that'll put some people off, and then they'll, you know, start ostracizing you, and you don't need that. You can do magic, you know, undercover and shit in the workplace, and do your rituals at home and deal with whatever you got to deal with. You got asshole supervisors, deal with that shit when you get off the job and go home and stir some shit up, what you need to do for self-defense, not out there to strike out and harm anyone and be vengeful and vindictive. Just being protective and guarding your space and, you know, protecting yourselves and so forth and so on. Because one thing that we have learned, most of us, is that if we have truth as our shields, the universe will back us up. I was watching a program last night where this man, these two guys committed murder, and one guy confessed, and he got life without parole. And the other guy, he didn't confess, but he was there, but they didn't have enough evidence to convict him, so he didn't get charged, and he didn't get any time as a result of not getting charged. But lo and behold, about 3 years later, he dropped dead of a heart attack. And from what I saw in the program, he wasn't an old man. So sooner or later, justice catches up with folks, and we don't have to do a spell or ritual or any damn thing. The universe will manifest and appear and handle its business with justice for real, for real. So thank y'all for listening. Bye now.